My name is Oliver Richters. I'm 28 years old from the Netherlands. I'm 7'2", 2m18 in length. The last 8 years, I've gained 70 kilos. Together with Men's Health, I will show you how I did this. A day in the life of the Dutch giant. First thing I want to do is get my metabolism up, going into a muscle building state. I do this by making a shake of dextrose and PeptiPro, so sugars and protein, both 20 grams. My breakfast consists of 6 eggs, 200 grams of oats, and 40 grams of whey protein. And my eggs are not the normal eggs you find in a supermarket. I use a pasteurized egg of 1 liter, so I can actually, on the gram exact, use 400 grams of eggs. My breakfast is the biggest meal of the day. It's 1400 calories and 85 grams of protein. I don't use regular oats, but instant oats that are already cooked and shredded. You can simply drink them, and they digest so fast that my stomach is empty at 12 o'clock. My biggest friend is my parrot, Kiwi. It's my little terrorist. If he could, he would eat as much as I do. After my breakfast, I make sure I make 4 prepped meals out of the 7 meals that I eat all day. When I started this lifestyle of consistently eating like every 2 or 3 hours, I did it like everyone, cooking my rice, baking my steak, and it simply took me too much time and I didn't want it anymore. My fridge is full of prepped food, rice, chicken, vegetables. I only have to pour it into a container, heat it up in the microwave at work or at home, and I'm ready to go. These 4 meals are always very simple. They consist of 200 grams of meat, 100 grams of vegetables, and 200 grams of pre-cooked rice or any other carb. People always ask me, what car do you own? Funny thing is that from Audi, the only car I fit in is the Audi A3. It's a small car, but the chair can actually go way back. When people go into my car, they sometimes ask me, did you sleep in your car? And it's because the chair is so up to the back that I can look in my rear window. If you see it, it's hilarious. The world is not made for this kind of height or size. In my home, I changed almost everything. The door frames, the simplest thing as a toilet seat, mirrors, the couch, everything is too small. Whenever I go outside my house, I know that the world is not adjusted to me. I accept it, it's okay. People ask me, are you not irritated? Because they see me in a chair and somewhere I can stand. It has become totally normal for me, which is a little bit absurd, but maybe you can realize that if you are at this height, you get used to it.
Klein, Sam.
Ja.
Ja. Leuk.
Ja.
Doe
ja.
Leuk. Nee, gewaardeerd mensen.
Ja, dank je wel.
Dank je.
Bye. At 9 o'clock, I arrive at Muscle Meat. It's an online sports supermarket that I created with my brother and his wife. All based on my own experience, what is missing in the supermarkets. Muscle Meat is all about convenience. We have so many ready-to-eat products where you can prep your meals within minutes. We started with only 4 products and in 5 years' time we are over 250 products, and every product that we introduce has my own thoughts and recipe behind it. All these products that I develop are based on fast, a lot of protein, convenience, and I make 4 meals in 10 minutes. It's Muscle Meat. So at 12 o'clock we all go and eat together. It might be a little bit weird for outsiders, but everybody takes their prepped food out of the freezers. We go to the microwaves, they put in their meals, and we just all stare at the microwaves waiting for the food. So my second meal of the day is one of the meals that I prepared in my kitchen. consists of 600 calories and between 50 and 60 grams of protein. Do I enjoy every meal I eat? I make sure every meal I eat is good, that my taste buds say, let's eat. I don't care which kind of meat I eat. What I do like is to switch constantly between those sources. But the thing is, if every day for so many years you eat 7 times a day, it's more of a lifestyle. You eat just every 3 hours and make sure you eat it. It's not like I'm looking forward to eat, I'm just hungry. It tastes good, let's eat. So around 3 o'clock, it's time for meal three. Sometimes you can't drop your work in an instant. So what I do is I just warm up my meal that I prepped that morning and just continue working behind my desk while I eat. Towards the end of the working day, I'm looking forward to my training. 2 things I need to do, eat again. So that's meal number four, and make my intra-workout shake. Those 60 grams of dextrose combined with the PeptoPro, they make sure I can keep going longer during the training. I need to start training with a full stomach. I can't skip a meal because at the end of the day, else I won't get 6400 calories inside of me. Not everybody can train with a full stomach. You can get nauseous, bloated. For me it works and I need those calories. So decide for yourself if you're going to train with a full stomach or not. So when I walk into the gym, first thing I do is always look who's training at the moment, because I'm training at Dojo Burning Heart. It's a gym where everybody has some kind of goal and everybody knows each other and what their background is. And it's always nice to greet some people and then go into your training. The nicest thing about a gym is that if people see that you're in your training, they know from, okay, let's not talk now, he's focusing. Another thing that's really important for me when I go to a gym is that they have a lot of free weights. Most exercises I actually don't fit. I don't fit in this one. And I also don't fit in that one. And this one irritates me the most. Even in the biggest gyms, I still experience tall people problems. For me, it's always really important that I can do my exercises full range to get that maximum stretch. Not every machine allows that. So this requires me to be more creative, train with free weights, and sometimes adjust exercises to my size. For the lat pull down, I can't do it full range of motion. I actually sit at a triceps machine. So where you normally do a triceps push down, I could sit on the floor and then I finally can reach all to the top and go down. So when I'm in the gym, my mind is ready, but my body still needs to have some sort of wake-up call. And that, for me, the warm-up is always very important. I do 2 or 3 sets, 15 reps, just to warm up. It immediately gives an impulse to my body. I actually notice that my eyes are getting more open and that I'm really ready to train. So it's like my mind and my body is going to be connected and they both know we're going for it for a full hour of training. For the last 8 years, I've trained each other day. And the main reason I train each other day, not every day, is that I do not repair that fast. I really believe you should never train if your muscle is not fully repaired. Other very important thing is how I trained those 8 years. I gained 70 kilos and actually I started like everyone else, I think. You go to the gym, you see some standard exercises, bench press, shoulder press. You start lifting 3 times 10 reps, probably. I actually gained with that in the first year 10 kilos, probably just because my body wasn't used to anything. So I was a little bit more eating, a little bit more training. And after that, I also gained 10 kilos, but then I flatlined. So that's the moment that you think, why am I not growing anymore? And that's also the thing where I search for help. I met many bodybuilding coaches. I've trained with many pros. I actually reached out to some people who also wanted to help me and just to see how they trained. And for instance, William Bonac, Kenneth Van Moger, everybody trains in a different way. It's like not one way how to increase your size in muscles, which made me think, what is the best way for me? So the one thing I noticed in these 8 years is that your body is an excellent adapter. Every 6 weeks I noticed my body got used to the different trainings I did. I wouldn't progress anymore in weights. I wouldn't progress anymore in reps. I wouldn't get as much pain or muscle aches as I used to when I did it the first time. So every 6 weeks I changed my routine. Before this interview, I wrote down what I did the last 8 years, and it was actually 19 different training ways. I seriously believe in the concept that you should not train longer than an hour. If you can't destroy 2 muscle groups in 1 hour, you haven't trained. So I still have to eat 3 times. And for meal number 5, that is directly after my training, just to make sure my muscles get enough protein to repair and everything that goes along with it. Usually I just eat at the bar at the gym. It saves me time, and after that I go home. Ja, natuurlijk.
Ja,
is a tall person stronger than a smaller person, or what happens? Where's the balance? I talked to Thor, his nickname, the strongest man of the world. Something that we discussed, that actually our both conclusion was that if a tall person and a smaller person start at the same level, the small person will be stronger because of the range of motion is shorter, but the giant eventually can rise by off everyone. You can build so much more weight and strength on that bigger frame. It takes much more time and everything, but the potential that a frame can reach is beyond a normal person. So eventually my goal isn't to be the strongest. I perform the sport bodybuilding, so I want to look good in the mirror. It gave me a lot more confidence. And now that I've reached this size and with my height, it's actually leading to a lot more, to the film industry. And it's really a dream of mine to use this body in horror movies, as bodyguards, as an ogre. That's really working out well at the moment.
You are very tall.
Yeah. Do I see this height as a curse? I think it was a curse. Maybe you can imagine that if you're 17 and you're already 2m10, and you go, when you're 20 or 19, you're 2m18. Everybody's staring at you. You don't really know what to do with it. It's pretty useless. And this sport and lifestyle gave me confidence. I think I made it into a gift instead of a curse. After my 20s, when I started gaining weight, I really enjoyed being so tall. And I want to show the world what I can do with it.
Mag jij even proberen zo te zitten? Ik weet hoe zwaar je bent.
Ja, doe maar.
Zo.
En dan werkt het even.
Okay, so we're in Amsterdam for the Men's Health cover shoot of the November edition, shooting with DeLorean. Girl who's 1m70, and really excited to see what kind of photos it will be.
Ja, het is inderdaad een SD. Ja.
So training each other day for 1 hour is like a small portion of the whole week, the time you're spending for that goal of gaining weight and muscles. The most important thing is what you do all those hours around it. And for me, that's eating every 3 hours. And sometimes that can be difficult, but I'll just give you a few examples. If you go to the cinema with your girlfriend, don't skip that meal. Just take your container with you and eat while you watch the movie. Also, when you're at a birthday, everybody eats cake, you eat your container. And if I go to a pizza restaurant, almost no meat on it, I have a secret bag of beef jerky with me. So for everything, there's always a solution, but you have to think up front, where am I going and can I eat there? If not, how am I going to solve that? For me, failing to plan is planning to fail. Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Je bent veel groter,
zeg maar. Heb je er één?
Hoi.
Hoi, zou je me op kunnen tillen?
Ja, ja, op mijn schouders zoals net, of
ja,
of wil je gewoon voor je zo... Hey little girl.
Say hi. Like a mommy. Like a mommy.
Yeah, sure. Woo! A lot of people. Thanks. That was great. Meal number 6 is the same one as my breakfast. I start with the biggest meal and I end with the biggest meal. Why do I end with the biggest meal? It's because I'm going to sleep and I want as much in my stomach as possible, which can be used to repair my body. Speaking about repairing, as you can see, I work, I train. It gives a lot of stress on my body, in my mind. So I always try to relax at the TV, eat slowly, just try to think about nothing so I can also fall asleep. My last meal is at 3 in the morning. So I wake up, I have my quark next to my bed. I eat, like 1 minute, go back to sleep, and that's meal number 7. So that was then the last meal of the day. I wake up again with an empty stomach. And the day starts over again, again, and again.
Ja. Oh, wacht, mag ik 1 keer?
Ja.
Wacht. Oh mijn god. Jezus.
Dankjewel. And that is a day in the life of the Dutch giant.